Well, Providence has just unveiled its latest big estimate of the Newgrange exploration prospect. The Irish exploration firm has also told its investors it could cost just $22.5 million to add an extra well to an upcoming program. Technical Director John O'Sullivan joins me on the line. John, thanks for your time. How likely is it that you'll add Newgrange onto the Druid program?
Well, obviously from the update that we've released this morning, it clearly demonstrates that there's very significant resource potential at Newgrange in the gas case, just north of 13 trillion cubic feet in place, and in the oil case, 9 billion barrels of oil. Our well cost estimate to drill this well, because it's a very shallow well, albeit it's in deep water, is just north of $20 million. So from a risk reward and cost to drill, it's actually very attractive if you have a rig in the basin. Recently, we completed a fundraising, which will see a rig coming into the Porcupine in 2017 to drill on the Druid prospect. So we are talking to potential co-venture partners to come in and add this well to the string of the program next year. And obviously, it is very attractive. It has got risk, but if it works, it can be very, very material, even for the very large international oil companies.
Well, you mentioned that it is attractive, but just how much potential does Newgrange have?
Well, Newgrange is an enormous structure. We map the top of the Cretaceous covers, the closure covers an area of four North Sea blocks, nearly 1,000 square kilometers, which is enormous by anybody's standards. It's really shallow below the seabed, about 500 meters below the mudline. And we expect porosities within the carbonate target to be very, very high because it's never been buried that deeply. So you have a combination of an early extensive feature with a very high porosity and with a crest to lowest closing contour height of about 300 meters means you've got an enormous tank. So the volumetric potential is enormous, as we've demonstrated with the RNS this morning. The things we think about are, is it likely to be charged with oil or gas? And how much source rock do we have available to the prospect to charge it? So certainly we know the tank size is enormous. The questions around the exploration paradigm then are, is it oil or is it gas? And how much source rock do we have available within the catchment of Newgrange to fill the trap?
Now, we touched on it slightly earlier, but in terms of funding, will it require a farm out for at least one of the wells?
Yeah, I mean, we've with the recent placing, we have secured the funding for our equity in the Druid exploration well. We are talking to potential farminees to come into that program. So by them coming into the program and reducing our costs on Druid, obviously it would free up some of the capital from the fundraising that was directed towards Druid. Also, we're talking to those parties about Newgrange, again, as a possible follow-on well that they might be interested in coming into.
And now, John, now that the details of this new license awards are known, how much has changed in terms of Ireland's standing for EMPs?
Well, I think the recent licensing round results have been extraordinary. I mean, if you look at the map of the Porcupine Basin in particular today versus where it was in 2004 when we first licensed, and in that round we were the only applicant to license in the Porcupine Basin. You know, the Irish state received 43 applications at a time when the oil price was very, very low, and when in an area that's deep water and relatively hostile. If you look at the map today, and the department published the second phase map yesterday morning, nearly the entire Porcupine Basin has now been licensed or is held under option. So it's been a very significant transformation of the Irish West Coast, I think probably driven by the results in the Flemish Pass, the discoveries that have been made there, in tandem with the well that we drilled with our partners led by Exxon in 2013, which demonstrated the presence of a significant oil-prone petroleum system in the southern Porcupine Basin.
Thanks, John. Good talking. Thanks for the update.
Okay. Great to talk.